the voice of the Timbers, Andy McNamara.
Good evening once again, everyone. Andy McNamara alongside John Strong, the Timbers, and the California Victory for the third consecutive league match tonight and the fifth and final meeting between these two sides here in 2007. They have been introduced, and that gives us time to run down the starting lineups. Brought to you by Portland General Electric, PGE. We do this every day. First for the visiting California Victory, Eric Reed, the very impressive goalkeeper, in goal for California tonight. They will start with what is listed as a 4-4-2 formation. We're deducing more of a 4-2-4 out of this. Luis Aguiar is the right back. Chris Schwartz, Omar Aguayo listed as a defender tonight. He's typically a midfielder, as is Hugo Casillas. In the middle, Ricardo Sanchez returns. Very impressive and very skilled player. Had to sit out the last match for California. He's in the midfield along with Federico Bianchi and Yuri Morales. Juan Epete also listed as a midfielder. Josh Hansen and Aaron Chandler are the strikers up top. Hansen, the leading scorer on the California Victory. Just three reserves listed on the bench. We're going to check into this, but I believe you have to have at least 15 players active for a USL 1 match, and if they have not done that, they could be in jeopardy of forfeiting this match. We are underway. We'll fill in the Timbers 11 for you as we get started here in the first minute. The Timbers in their green uniforms from head to toe, moving right to left across your internet browser here this evening. California, at least they look like a different team tonight, John. They're in a uniform combination that we have not seen yet. Orange jerseys with black shorts and orange socks. So it looks like a little bit of Ducks against Beavers here tonight for those in-state fans based on the uniform combos here at PGE Park. Early whistle against California. Restart for Scott Thompson. Defensive side of the middle third for Portland. Josh Wicks, obviously, the starter in goal tonight for Portland. A 4-4-2. Here's an early chance, a shot and a save. What a save by Reed. Kiki Lara from 20 yards, a full volley. And that was ticketed for a postage stamp, upper V right-hand side. Reed has to knock it over the bar and gives up the corner. Andrew Greger will take the corner. Back line for Portland, left to right. Griffin, Scott Thompson, Cameron Knowles, and Lee Morrison. Greger whips it in. Reed can't contain it, but the shot attempt by Knowles doesn't go on goal. California looks to counter quickly. In the midfield, Tom Polo returns tonight. Along with Andrew Greger, the wingers will be Kiki Lara and Luke Kramelmeier. Looks like Kiki's going to start on the left side. He sends a nice ball through for Bagley, who is taken down. And our friend, the referee, Mr. Hedajet, Tika Hedajet, was the referee in the Open Cup match against Seattle, who flagged Cameron Knowles for a very, very controversial red card. A card that the Seattle coach even apologized for after the match was over.
Well, I will say this about his first decision. That was a good sliding challenge there. The defender came from behind, but he got nothing but ball, and then he got Bagley afterwards. California looking very unsure of themselves early. That first chance from Kiki Lara created when Scott Thompson's ball, and just it wasn't a very good header from the defender. Straight up in the air, just to his right. Laura hit it on the volley. Good save by Reed. And then Reed fumbles the corner kick, creating a chance. California again right afterwards, giving up possession in the middle. And that's what led to the challenge there on Bagley. And again, here you go. Andrew Greger, a chance on a free kick.
Bagley and Jordan are the starters up top. Here's Greger bending it in off the free kick. And this time, Reed hangs on. Yeah, it was very interesting to see him fumble that corner. He's been money for California against the Timbers, despite the fact that he has only losses to show for his efforts against the Timbers.
Well, I think that was just because he had a defender there on that near post, and there was a bit of unsurety whether the defender was going to clear it out because it was very low, or if Reed was going to get it, and so it was in that confusion that he bobbled it, but in the end didn't get punished for it.
Third minute, 0-0 from PGE Park in Portland. Down the right side, by our vantage point, California working the ball. Yuri Morales now with a throw. Plays it in, gets it back, can't contain. It'll be a throw for Portland deep in their defensive third. I mentioned the four forwards essentially for California, their natural positions. Morales, Epete, Hansen, and Chandler. And I mentioned also they list Aguayo and Casillas as defenders. They are both attacking-minded midfielders, at least in the versions of the lineup for the victory we have seen so far this season. So they are sparing no expense from an attacking standpoint to try to put one past Josh Wicks. They've been shut out four straight matches against the Timbers. Wicks, a long clearance. Jordan goes up, gets ahead on it, knocks it forward.
You know, going back to the issue of the referee tonight, and those of you who didn't catch the game, it was the Open Cup game against Seattle. He gave it was really an even game, a number of yellow cards, and a red card was given to Cameron Knowles for an elbow that pretty much no one outside of him felt was a red card, including head coach of the Seattle Sounders. A lot of other yellow cards, too. Timbers certainly feeling very hard done by there.
Here's a chance in front for California. And I believe that's Chandler. Maybe that was Bianchi, actually, trying to center. It was Bianchi. Now he'll take a throw-in.
And so you'll hear the Timbers army tonight getting on him much more so than they would usually, and I'm curious to see how.
Hansen plays it through a little bit too far in front of Epite.
How Gavin Wilkinson's protestations as normal might be affected by that.
Jordan, a long run. Reed bobbled for a moment off the long clearance from Josh Wicks. California, it looks more unsure on this artificial turf tonight than they did the entire match on Friday. I think they would be more comfortable with it second time around.
Well, there is the only difference tonight, it's slight. 7 o'clock kickoff time, earlier than normal, certainly earlier than the 8 o'clock kickoff time on Friday, and so there's quite a bit of sunlight on the pitch, really one half of the pitch, if you kind of cut it down the middle from goal to goal, is in sunlight, and so Reed, the goalkeeper, is going to have sun in his eyes if he's looking to his right for balls in, and that could have an effect, as until probably late in the first half, the shadows will cover the entire field, and we'll be back to where it usually is for Timbers games.
6th minute, 0-0. Gregor on the restart from distance, tries to find Ryan Jordan. And we don't want to belabor the point about the official, but it's such a big match. Open Cup, there's financial issues at stake for those teams. It was just a very unfortunate situation where a single whistle turned the entire momentum of the match. And the Timbers had a 1-0 lead before that happened. The ensuing penalty kick was converted, and then Seattle was able to play a man up for the remainder of the match. And as skilled and talented as they are from an attacking standpoint, it was only a matter of time before they got that second and eventual game-winning goal. It wasn't just Portland's way. There was a card I remember that was called against Jake Bassanio for the Sounders that, you know, certainly was not card-worthy late in the second half, at least from the consistency that we've seen from officials so far here in 2007. Timbers offside is Bagley. Good call there by the assistant referee on the far side.
There's Aguayo there stepping up. You know, I think sometimes referees are given too much credit for their rules in games, but it is fair to say a red card that, again, everyone universally said wasn't deserved. Well, here's Brian Jordan down. This isn't good.
Jordan went knee to knee, had to come out of Friday's match, and now he is definitely in some pain, and it's his left leg once again. He's back to his feet now.
And he said after that game, we didn't get the live interviews, of course, because we had some technical problems, but he did say afterwards it was just a knee-to-knee collision, just hurt a little bit. And, you know, I asked him about, you know, how scared everyone must have been when he was down, and he said, well, you know, if I'm down for a while, then be concerned, but I'm pretty resilient, as we've seen. To finish the thought, that decision by the referee did affect the rest of that game. Red cards have a tendency to do that, particularly when they're not necessarily deserved. Hopefully not much to talk about regarding the referee at the end of tonight's game, and hopefully it's exclusively the teams and the players deciding what happens today.
8th minute, 0-0 from PGE Park. Tom Podol plays it wide for Kiki Lara down the near side. Too far of a run for Kiki. You have to wonder if Brian Jordan might not accidentally pass it to someone in black and orange tonight as well. He's a rookie, first-year player. Played his soccer last year at Oregon State University wearing those black and orange uniforms. Ball down the near side, touchline. Jordan can't catch up to it. Schwartz clears it out. Lee Morrison heads it on for Tom Poeltl. That's what Lee will bring to tonight's match. Very good in the air, winning those 50-50s. Chance for Kremelmeyer down the right side. Centers in front. Player taken down. It's Jordan, and they say play on. Timbers still had advantage, and now California clears it out. Now, Jordan may have sort of put himself in the air there before he was knocked and then went down right in front of the Timbers army. They did not enjoy that, but...
Yeah, I think it was the right decision. Jordan just kind of threw his body there towards the ball. It was off balance and, you know, a collision with the defender, but certainly not a foul.
Ball in the middle. Sanchez plays it on the left side. Now they go up top. That's Hansen for Casillas. Casillas pokes it forward. Some tight passing here by the Victory, and the Timbers able to clear it out. 10th minute. We'll keep an eye on the clock for you. There's a new record at stake. Potential new record at stake for the Timbers. Scoreless minutes. Rapidly approaching. Poor touch there for Morrison. Trying to hook up with Leonard Griffin. So that gives California a throw near side of their attacking third. And they've got to score at some point, don't they? It's been four plus matches for the California Victory against the Timbers. Here's Sanchez. Very dangerous. Moving forward. Finds Yuri Morales. Winds up the shot. Nice play by Griffin to step in. This will give a corner kick to the Victory in the 11th minute. Ricardo Sanchez will jog over to take it.
Starting to see some of what we saw Friday night, which is California building the attacking pressure by basically throwing everyone forward, leaving just two back. Tonight it looks like Aguayo and Schwartz drawing the short straws to stay back and babysit Brian Jordan.
Sanchez knocks it in off the outside netting. This will be a goal kick for Josh Wicks.
And again, that's where the Timbers had most of their attacking chances. That's where they got their goal, was on counterattacks on Friday night when California would throw everyone up and the Timbers would very quickly break the other way. And the goal they scored was on a corner kick. It went straight to Josh Wicks. He had a quick punt out that was laid off to Scott Thompson running on. He played a ball into Brian Jordan. It took all of 5 or 6 seconds, and there were no defenders back. A lot of space available for the Timbers. They put the goal in.
Jordan drawing a foul on Schwartz. Nice free kick chance here for Greger. Inside at 35 yards.
He can go for goal, I think, from this position. He's close enough here that if he wants to, he can really go for a shot here instead of just trying to find a teammate's head.
You can see the remnants of the American football lines here, so you know exactly where 10 yards are, and the Victory line is not 10 yards away from the ball. They set up a big wall, creeping ever so forward. Greger calling it out right now, but they're not going to move the wall. Then they move before he strikes it. It'll end up as a corner, though, and Greger will take that.
Now, that was interesting there. The referee on that free kick, you'd usually see him somewhere in the box at kind of a side view. He was actually behind the entire play such that he really was not in a good position at all to see anything going on in the box. He's got his linesman there to help out, but that was very curious positioning there in the last free kick chance.
Here's Greger from the near flag. He'll swing it out. Inside the six, Schwartz got up on it, and the Victory cleared out. Settled by Kiki Lara. Flicks it over his defender and pursues the ball. Schwartz is there, though. He'll clear it down the line. The Victory give up a turnover there. Tom Poeltl stepping up from Portland. California clear it up. Scott Thompson knocks it back. Sloppy passing both ways here. Bagley. Lara. Timbers looking to hook up with Jordan again. Bagley heads it into no man's land, and it's picked off by California. 13th minute. Whistle and a ticky-tack foul on Kiki Lara inside the center circle. So we're a minute away from Portland setting a new USL 1 Timbers record for scoreless minutes. Four straight clean sheets. Last goal scored against Portland was a goal by Montreal in a 1-1 draw here at PGE Park. Whistle and a foul. Poeltl called for the foul from behind. Sanchez will operate from 45 yards away. Timbers set up one man in front of him. It's Brian Jordan. Jordan maybe 8 yards away from the ball. Sanchez whips a low one in. Cleared out by Scott Thompson. Oh, foul called against California. Epite just lost his footing and drug down a green jersey in the process. 15th minute, we've got it. New record.
378 minutes.
Long restart into the box. Wisely, Aguilar lets it go, and that'll be a goal kick for Reed.
The only thing we have to compare it to for the NASL days was four consecutive clean sheets that Mick Poole had in 1978. We don't have a minute streak because we don't have access to when the goals were scored and games either end of that streak. But a Portland Timbers team, regardless of the league, has never had five consecutive clean sheets, and that's what they would have if they can give California another goose egg tonight.
Tom Podol overruns the ball and tackled down for the Timbers is Luke Kremelmeyer, and another foul against the Victory. So lots of whistles early in this one.
Not surprising. That's what we've seen in all these games. Is California is certainly a physical team. They get plenty of cards in every game. I think they won a streak of a few matches in a row with a red card. They're just a tough physical team, and Timbers certainly blue-collar, work ethic, defensive-minded. They're tough and physical, too, so 40, not a team shy.
40 yards away, Andrew Greger plays it near side for Leonard Griffin. Griffin dribbles his man, now takes it back toward the middle. He's knocked down, and here's a card. Speak of the prowess by California to pick up cards. It's Josh Hansen picking up the first paperwork here in the 16th minute.
I think that was just what they would call persistent infringement. Just one too many fouls by Hansen there. The referee finally had enough and gonna give out the yellow card.
Hansen has four goals on the year for California. He's their leading scorer. Greger looking to play that to the side of the box, but Sanchez nips it out. Now Kremelmeyer steals it, pulling, moving forward, back for Sanchez though. Kremelmeyer had it stripped away. Ball too far on this artificial turf, rolls into Scott Thompson, who plays it back for Wicks. Wicks clears it out to midfield. Now Epite on it there for California. 17th minute, 0-0 from PGE Park. Andy McNamara along with John Strong tonight. Our next match will be Thursday when the Timbers' Northwest nemesis, Vancouver, comes to town. Part of the Cascadia Cup Series. And then it's off for a pair of back-to-back road matches down in the southeastern United States. Busy stretch coming for Portland. Here's Bianchi for California. Loads up the left foot. Now he shoots, and it's deflected to score. And that is unfortunate. Nothing Josh Wicks could do. And the goal will be credited, I believe it'll be Chandler, who didn't mean to hit it, but it hit him and then went past Wicks.
You know, I think I have to take culpability here. Because just about 10 seconds before that goal went in, I grabbed my piece of paper where I had notes on the scoreless streak and went back and calculated the number of minutes coming into the game so that if the Timbers did give up a goal, I could come back and say what it was. Suffice to say, by thinking about preparing for the Timbers to give up a goal, they did minutes later. Kind of unfortunate. But again, just nothing Wiz could do about it.
Here's a chance the other way. Jordan, though, can't slip behind the last line of defense, which was Aguayo.
Deflected shot, and the original shot came in from just outside the box, and that's what we saw that Friday night where all the chances were from distance, and we said Timbers are fine with that. It's going to take either a deflection or just a fantastic effort to beat Josh Wicks. And you know, you hate to say something like this, but it wasn't really the defense's fault at all. That goal went in. It was an unfortunate deflection. It still counts the same, of course. The Timbers are still losing, and they have to get a goal back here. But
and the one thing I'll say about that too is Brian Jordan tries to corral a pass, lays it off a little bit too far behind Bagley. Bianchi You know, he'll get credit for the assist. He actually, in my estimation, though, made a poor decision. He had a wide open shot that he passed up and then instead took a shot in traffic once he realized that he hung on to the ball too long and didn't really take a good shot. Wicks had it covered, but Chandler just happened to be walking past and it hit him. And it redirected it. So if you're going to give up a goal to end a streak, you'd hate to give up a sort of an accidental goal. But
I'd rather it be something pretty special.
Two players go down in the box for Portland.
So the streak ends at 382 minutes. That is the new mark for the USL Timbers. And four consecutive clean sheets still stands as the all-time Timbers record. Time to start another streak.
California has wins against Vancouver and Montreal this year. So for those of you who think they are just the worst team in the history of pro soccer, that is not the case. The Timbers have just had their number. They're four straight.
Well, I think with California, it's not a matter of a lack of talent. It's a lack of consistency. Because as you say, they get up for those games and they get some great wins over some good teams. And then they struggle against the Timbers and others. So when they put it together, they're a very good team.
Epete plays it to the top of the box. Morrison picks it off. Plays one down the near side. Mishits that one. Not a good choice there by Lee Morrison.
Yeah, we'll see what the Timbers' response is here to giving up that goal. Because certainly 3 points here are very important. Even though they've already won four games, you hate to give away any points at home. Particularly when you've got all those road matches to end the year.
Chandler has it picked away. And just to demonstrate how, you know, it's a game of inches. Most sporting contests are. But you've got a guy like Chris Bagley who does not have a goal this season. And then Chandler scores his first of the year on a goal like that. So the stat sheet or the box score doesn't always tell the true tale. Knocked onto the Portland bench. This will be a Timbers throw on their offensive side of the middle third.
Or will it?
Referee overrules it.
Yeah, the linesman signaled a Timbers throw. Referee came in to overrule it. And the Timbers are not happy about this. Well, they're going to give it a foul for something. But Gavin Wilkinson already barking at the referee.
He has no fans over on that bench. You have to wonder, too, some of the players, you know, Gavin Wilkinson wanted to give Justin Thompson a night off as sort of a reward. Let him rest his body a little bit for his play recently. But the lineup the last two nights against California, last two matches against California, has been so effective with Olam in there. And you have to wonder if some of those guys are over on the bench right now going, wish we were in there.
Well, but that being said, you know, we've talked about the Timbers' depth. You've got to test that depth. It's no good having a bunch of great players if they're going to sit on the bench all the time. You've got to give them time to prove themselves. If for no other reason than prepare for a situation where you get late in the season and you've picked up injuries and yellow cards, and, you know, it's not a decision to have some of those first-team players out.
Gregor and Podol having some words. California on the back line. 23rd minute, 1-0 victory. Reed under pressure from Jordan has to clear it out. Aguilar up for Hansen. California with really no bench personnel whatsoever tonight. They've got a backup goalkeeper and then two midfielders, Mike Munoz and Chuck Kim, who were not listed. Kim was not on the sheet on Friday night, so they must have sent Ortiz home. He had to sit out tonight anyway because of yellow card accumulation, and then brought Kim up for the match here today.
Another interesting note here brought to our attention by Mark Kostic, head of media relations. First time the Timbers have trailed in a league match since a June 9th loss to Rochester 2-1. That is 7 matches ago. The Timbers not just giving up a goal, but the fact they haven't trailed in over a month.
Oh, Gregor picks up a yellow card for a foul on Casillas. So So first piece of paperwork for Portland here in the 24th minute. Timbers down a goal. California restarts, brings it into the center circle. Work it wide for Casillas over on the left side. Wasted ball over the top. It'll be tracked by Cameron Knowles. He gets there and clears it over the touchline. This will be a throw.
Now they're going to give it as offsides. The California player there in an offside position. It was a good job by the linesman to wait and raise his flag until he became involved in the play. So the Timbers will get this right back. Haven't been overly impressed with the immediate response to the goal 6 minutes ago from Portland. Still just a little bit out of sorts here, trying to gain possession and create chances. And Andrew Gregor still barking at the referee about his yellow card. Got to watch himself here.
Low ceiling of clouds here on a hazy and muggy day by Northwest standards. Early kickoff tonight, as is typically the case on Sundays. The light standards are on, but not necessary at this point. California with that 1-0 lead as we're in the 25th minute.
It's worth saying, too, as we said earlier, the Timbers' attacks on Friday night were largely based on counterattacks when California would pour numbers forward. Well, they don't need to do that right now. They're sitting back a little bit more, as you would expect with a 1-0 lead, and so it's up to Portland to, without all that artificial extra space created, still become dangerous in the attacking end.
California with the bulk of the possession here thus far. Yuri Morales has it poked away. Here's Bagley. Takes it a little wider than he probably meant to. Now lays it off for Leonard Griffin. Off for Gregor now. Griffin will go on a run through the box. Bagley got a toe on it. Aguilar, though, picks it away, and now California will clear it out.
Two poor first touches in a row there from Bagley to end what should have been a good attacking opportunity there on the giveaway.
Sanchez for California. Montreal has lost tonight 3-0 against the other last place team to start the day, Minnesota. Another turnover, just a sloppy match to this point.
And that is
here at PGE.
Fine by California. They want this to be as ugly as possible. They're perfectly fine with it.
Timbers just aren't connecting on anything. Ball into Bagley. Knocked away by the victory. Stepping up, though, is Griffin to keep possession. But even he has difficulty on that first touch. Now Griffin gets tackled down. That'll be a foul and a free kick opportunity for the Timbers. Timbers have been so good on the set pieces this year. They did not have... Oh, they're not going to call a foul. It's just a throw-in. Unlucky there for Portland. Leonard Griffin, top of the box. Too far for Bagley. It goes in on Reed, the keeper.
You know, Gregor's better watch himself there, as that last ball was played in. The opposite number 13, Sanchez. Gregor just kind of knocked him down off the ball, intentional or not. The referee was right up in Gregor's face, using his kind of motion with his hand, calm down, calm down. And Andrew's certainly a feisty lad, I think, if we could say anything about him over the years. Already a yellow card, and now Gregor just got knocked down in the middle.
He is still on his back, and already we've got David Haig loosening on the far side. Timbers bring it down the near side. Jordan, Gregor's still on his back. Down by the end line. This will be a corner for the Timbers.
Now they're going to give it a foul, I think. The California player, they're throwing a forearm right at Jordan. We may see multiple cards here. He's
right
upset about
nose.
It.
Jordan can't believe it. That
Gregor's still down.
Nothing has been pulled yet. Jordan really got smacked. You can just tell his eyes are watering just as, like they would if he got punched in the face.
And it was, I think, Epete who hit Gregor in the middle, and Gregor's still down. I think if Gavin Wilkinson is smart, he may want to take Andrew Gregor off now, not just for the injury, but the fact that he's really starting to get after the referee, and the last thing the Timbers need is for him to get a second yellow card. Referee now consulting with his fourth official, see if there's anything that punishment needs to be given out for that. But
well, the one thing, you know, Gavin Wilkinson obviously very in tune as to what's going on with Gregor, because the minute that he knocked over Sanchez, David Haig was up off the bench and warming up. So I think this will definitely be an early exit for Gregor tonight. Hopefully by the hand of his coach and by the hand of the referee.
Yeah, I think that'll be very smart. You hate to have Gregor out because he does so much for this team in possession and in creating attacking chances, but better to be playing with the 11 and Gregor off the field than to keep him on and end up with only 10. Well, we've got a moment. One other very surprising result we can tell you about now. It's a third-round match in the U.S. Open Cup taking place today. Carolina has defeated the Chicago Fire of Major League Soccer by a goal to nil at home. Carolina second for our third from bottom in the USL, and Chicago certainly struggling quite a bit this year in MLS, but that's still an upset. So Carolina, yet another USL team beating an MLS team, advancing to the quarterfinals. We'll have much more on that match and others at halftime today.
If you're the Timbers, you're rooting for every USL team, not just for your own league's status, but also because that just means more matches for them. And
well, let me correct you. You're not rooting for Seattle, bro. But outside of that, I think it's a fair point.
Well, I don't know. Seattle's a first-place team right now. But how does a Timbers fan root for Burpo? Here's a two-man wall set up. For those of you who may not know, Burpo now plays for Chivas USA, Seattle's opponent. Kremelmeyer to the back post. Oh, my goodness. The ball was headed across the goal mouth by Jordan. Great idea. Cameron Knowles was on the doorstep, but the ball took a next turf hop, and it was cleared away by California. It'll be a corner kick for Kremelmeyer.
How on earth Jordan got up to that one?
Here's Gregor back on the pitch. Gregor calling for the ball. He's wide open at the top right edge of the box. Kremelmeyer's corner kick cleared away. Hansen got it up for Chandler. Oh. And now Hodel goes down.
Clear foul. This is really getting nasty, and the California's coach on the other side having to be restrained by the fourth
yellow
official right
card
now.
For Casillas. And you talked about it earlier, John, where California went through a stretch this season where they had a red card a match for two or three in a row, and I would not be shocked at all if we see one eventually here tonight. The way things are boiling right now, we're only in the 31st minute. And, you know, it would be just moronic for them to do that. They have the lead. First lead they've had all year against the Timbers. First goal they've scored against the Timbers. They lead 1-0 here in the 31st minute. Gregor on the restart. Plays a high one in. Here's a chance in front. Shot. Score! Kremelmeyer for Knowles. And it's 1-1. All set up by Gregor.
Wow. For me, that's Luke Kremelmeyer's goal. Eric Reed, the goalkeeper, came out to collect. Kremelmeyer got there first, was able to just get enough of his hand to flick it past the goalkeeper. And Knowles in the end sneezed, and it went in. And keep in mind, Luke Kremelmeyer, a guy who hasn't played a lot this year, really trying to make an impact. He impressed me early when he came on as a sub late in that match Friday night, really creating the goal there. Good response by Portland off a free kick. Great to see Luke Kremelmeyer get involved.
Far side linesman is getting the business.
I think they might be arguing that Kremelmeyer obstructed with Reed, which I disagree with. He was exclusively playing for the ball. He was looking at the ball, and he got there first. Unless there was something else having to do with the celebrations or arguments afterwards. But great response, and now it's a whole new ball game. 1-1.
1-1. The Timbers, who have really, to be completely frank, have played poorly through the first half hour in this one for the most part. Putting it together on that one. Another magic ball from Gregor. And Kremelmeyer, that's not his strength. Even though he was the leading scorer last year, I mean, I can't think of an instance where he used his head to set up a goal or an assist. Great job to sky up on that one. And Knowles, you or I, John, could have scored that goal. Wide open at the back post, walked in the net with it. Cameron with his second goal of the season.
Well, and I love to see Kremelmeyer get involved. It's a guy, even if he's going to be coming off the bench, very talented player who's just, you know, bad luck, injuries, and whatever else against him this year that he hasn't produced much. It's only good things for the Timbers if Kremelmeyer is involved in making things happen.
This could fire up California in a bad way for them even more, too, by relinquishing the lead. We already saw some frustration and some fouls before the goal. Offside called against Portland.
Actually, Andrew Gregor there is that ball played and basically just shoved his defender down. I still think that Gavin Wilkinson needs to take Andrew Gregor off. As good as he is, yes, he created the goal. He's got a yellow card. It was a clear shove. It's only going to end badly, I think, for Gregor if he keeps going on like this. I really think Gavin needs to take him off. Maybe he's trying to wait to the half, but just very thin ice right now for the Timbers leader.
Ideally, Portland gets a second goal here, takes the lead. As we saw, you know, just one touch of the ball from Gregor changed the complexity of this entire match. That's why you take more chances with a player like that than the guy at the end of the bench.
You just wish he wasn't so darn feisty. If you could get the Andrew Gregor player and change the mentality a little bit, you'd have something truly special.
Here's Sanchez, bends it in.
But he's unfortunately, for the same reasons why you love to have him on your team, always going to be a little bit of a liability, just with his hot-headed nature. That's why we say it's the guy that you love to have him on your side and you absolutely hate to play against him.
California goes back to the keeper, Reed. Timbers put pressure up with three men. Victory, work it around. Casillas left with a ball. Chandler, though, totally mishits this. Scott Thompson had it tackled away. It'll be a throw for Portland in front of the California bench. Both coaches have really had a go thus far at the referee in this one, so neither Gappa pleased. Wicks guns it near side as the Timbers switch field for Leonard Griffin. 36th minute, 1-1 is our score. California scoring their first goal of the year against Portland, snapping the Timbers four straight clean sheets. Here's Kremelmeyer serving this one in, looking for Bagley. Now he'll track it down near the touchline, lets it go, and it'll be a throw for Scott Thompson. Just inside the top of the attacking third, 36th minute. Timbers also have an unbeaten record at home on the line tonight. They've done very well playing from behind this year. Only two losses on the season in league play. One against Seattle. One against Rochester, both on the road. But the Timbers have had some draws. They've had some victories where they've come from behind. Doesn't seem to rattle them. And it didn't do so here early in the first half as they went down 1-0 in the 18th minute. Fought back with a goal in the 32nd.
David Hag no longer warming up for Portland, but Luke Harrington is getting loose.
I think Brian Jordan may be another player that comes off for the Timbers, just to give his body a little bit of a break.
It's sad you have to say that about a 22-year-old.
Bianchi. Morales. Too much space here. Chance, right-footed shot. Hansen, it's deflected. Now, you like to see those shots from distance because you know Wicks can cover them, but too many bodies in front that time. The Timbers defense getting in the way more than anything, not helping out their keeper there.
Well, the difference there, too, Friday night when it was shots from distance, there were a number of Timbers players in front. It was hard to squeeze something through. That time, the Timbers just parting right in front, and there was a wide-open shooting lane there. California player had the look at the entire goal, and then just put it off target.
Like a handball, and it was inside the center circle. Restart coming for Portland. They play it quickly. Leonard Griffin up for Bagley. Bagley knocked from behind. Can't find Gregor. Picked away. Nifty move by Bianchi. Bianchi for Epite. Epite marked by Scott Thompson. Gets it caught in the wickets. Tom Podol in support. Knocks it away for Kremelmeyer. Back for Podol. Podol will clear it out as there's a man down for California.
Is that Epite?
Appears to be.
I didn't see where he got hit. He definitely, that entire last little rush there for California, they seem to be just that slightest bit out of control, kind of reaching for the ball on their touches.
California with just two field players available tonight on the bench.
They're both up now getting warm. you know, certainly both of these teams, we said it earlier, it's for the Northwest Human. But even though not all these players are necessarily from the West Coast, these are two West Coast teams. So at the least they're not used to playing in very humid conditions this year in the weather they're normally training in every day. And you wonder, especially given that we had a very humid and warm evening on Friday night, if that will have an effect as we go along with guys getting fatigued, getting cramps, things of that nature.
Epate will be helped off. He'll likely check back on, though, in a moment. California without a trainer, so Nick Wald has to do double duty. I'm sure Nick just loves that. Especially when a couple of these guys have actually had a go at Nick in the training room and down on the field. That's what happens when you see the same faces so many times in such a short period of time in a competitive environment. Fortunately, Ratee's not here tonight because I can pretty much guarantee he could have a compound fracture and Nick Wald would go nowhere near him. Andrew Greger will take a corner kick. California getting a little lazy on the back line. Greger from the near flag will swing it through the 6-yard box. No bend on that one whatsoever. And it floats just too high. It'll be taken out by Bianchi. Epate is back, marked by Podol. Kremelmeyer came to help out. Morales with it now. Nice 1-2 between Josh Hansen and Epate. Hansen, a nice player. No Fitzgerald, we should also mention tonight for California. Not even available in reserve. Ricardo Sanchez in the middle. Casillas on the far side. Turns it over. Kremelmeyer tackled down. And a restart on Portland's offensive side of the middle third. 1-1 our score in the 41st minute. Timbers' goal differential continues to impress. Plus 11 coming in. Last year, while Portland threw 13 matches, also had a winning record, believe it or not. You think of 2006 and you just think of losing, at least I do, but Portland was 5-4-4 at one point last year. They'd scored nearly as many goals as they have this year, but they had allowed more than twice as many.
Well, they were near the top of the standings early last year, but it was the reverse situation where they had played so many more games than other teams in the standings. It was kind of fool's gold. Well, you know, we thought an early change for the Timbers. Instead, here's an early substitution for California here in the 42nd.
So they burned one of their two field players on the bench early. How bad must Aguayo have been playing from the coach's perspective? He is fired up right now. Aguayo, that is. Greger on the restart. Drives it into the wall that couldn't have been more than 6 feet from him, or six yards, rather. It'll end up as a throw for the Timbers. Greger with the sunshine beating in his face. Knocks it in for Kremelmeyer, gets it back. Now Sanchez will look to clear it out for California. Knocks it off of Kremelmeyer, and that'll set up a throw. Deep in the defensive third for the victory. 43rd minute. 1-1 the score. Casillas plays it in. Ball stripped away. That was Munoz, by the way, that came in for Aguayo. I don't think we mentioned that.
You know, as you look ahead here, the final 2 minutes of the first half and into the second, obviously it's a very important 3 points for California because they don't want to lose a fifth consecutive match to this team, and they're trying to get up off the bottom of the table into the playoff range.
Kiki Lara sends it in. Jordan taps it down. Oh, my goodness. That would have been a tremendous goal.
Now, the flag was up, and when it counted, I disagree. I think he was right even with the last defender there. But it wouldn't count anyway.
What a job, though, by Jordan to bring that ball down, and he brought it down in a way that Reed then could not corral it. Had to back off. Then Jordan somehow got a flick on it. Good thing that didn't go in, because that would have been a shame.
You know, these 3 points, though, also I think very important to Portland. It would be just a great psychological lift to finish off this team 5-for-5. Be a great psychological lift for them to be in first place. But going up into a match Thursday against Vancouver, the importance of which I don't know really can be overstated for both teams, for the rivalry and for the standings standpoint. To have momentum, to be ahead in the standings, would just mean so much for Portland. If they can come from behind now and get another goal and get this win tonight.
Well, as for competitive as the Timbers have been over the years, too, they have not fared well against teams based on the West Coast. So it's they want to make California an opponent in their own backyard that they can deal with and make up for the fact that they've struggled so mightily against Vancouver and on and off against Seattle. 45 minutes have been played. We're in stoppage time now. Just a minute indicated, despite two goals and flurry of cards. Leonard Griffin runs into Morales. Foul on Griffin. Restart for California. And it will be back on their defensive side of the middle third.
Morales, they're arguing he should have been given advantage because he was still moving forward even after the foul, and he probably shouldn't have been given advantage there.
Morales, top of the box, Chandler. Chandler works it wide. Munoz is over there. Cuts it back into the box. Knocked out by Knowles. Headed away by Morrison. And the Timbers look to clear it out. A couple of players collide, Munoz and Kremelmeyer. Sun breaking through the clouds, causing some problems over on the far side of the field. Jordan continues to buzz. Now, here comes Kremelmeyer. 2v4, but he brings it into the box. Kremelmeyer across in front. Jordan swung and missed. Nearly 2-1 here at the end of stoppage time. That would have been a backbreaker going into the locker room for California.
Well, Jordan made that happen because when that ball was played to Kremelmeyer, Jordan was very much offside, but he immediately signaled to the referee, "I'm not involved in the play," raised his hand, so the flag didn't come up. But then, I think he took it away from Bagley. I think it was meant for Bagley. He was right in front. He was setting his body, getting ready to hit that, and Jordan stole it in the last second, swung and missed, and it got by Bagley.
Just shows the speed of Jordan. He was offside, as you mentioned, John. He sprinted back the opposite direction while his teammates were going forward to remove himself completely from the play, and then he was the first man back on the rush. Bagley just flicks it over the top. This should do it in the first half.
Given that we've played 2 minutes now, stoppage time, and they signaled one. There we go.
Three whistles, and the Timbers, despite giving up their first goal in nearly 400 minutes, have to feel fairly decent about themselves right now as they head into the locker room. Coming back from a one-goal deficit, they have tied the score at one through 45 minutes of play. The Timbers in the victory jog off the field. Halftime comes your way next. It's the Portland Timbers in the California victory, all knotted up at one goal apiece on the Portland Timbers Broadcast Network.
My name's Joe. And this is my wife, Virginia, and we're
the
Butts. Yeah, we live here at Cannon Beach in Oregon.
Third log on the left.
We don't normally do radio ads.
Or talk.
Right, but we want everyone to know there are people who don't want us here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they call us discarded.
Trash.
They call us trash. I don't even know what to say to that one. You know, it's gotten so bad that last year the people who clean up trash all over Oregon.
NPGE.
Yeah, and their partner, PGE, well, they came in and hauled off 10,000 of us cigarette butts.
Not even an apology?
No, nothing. And the frustrating thing is...
It ruined the summer potluck.
Yeah, well, All right. Now, that's not what I was going to say, but you're absolutely right. It's just wrong.
This is Jack McGowan with Solve. For 15 years, we partnered with Portland General Electric and their volunteers to make Oregon a cleaner place. To join us, visit portlandgeneral.com.
Reliable. What's it mean? To me, it means durable, honest. You know, like your favorite power tool, that old college t-shirt, or Les Schwab. When it comes to my car, it needs to be reliable, too. The one place that I rely on, Les Schwab.
Adventure Days, company-wide, over 200,000 instant prizes. Plus, enter to win one of 36 Polaris Sportsman 500 ATVs. Compliments of your local Polaris dealer and your Les Schwab tire centers.
This just in, breaking news from our special agent, Aaron E. Sherrance. Go ahead, special agent.
Overpriced auto insurance is trying to take over the world.
Will you be able to stop it in time?
Fortunately, overpriced auto insurance seems to lose power whenever it hears about eSurance Online Auto Insurance.
That's because eSurance offers affordable rates and great discounts.
And you can compare rates instantly online.
Join the fight to save yourself hundreds on auto insurance.
Get your fast free quote from eSurance.com today.
Not available in all states.
.382 minutes between goals given up for the Portland Timbers. An impressive streak, but the fact that it ends mean they had to play from behind, and now at the half they are even with the California victory at one goal apiece. Welcome back to PGE Park, everyone, and the Portland Timbers Broadcast Network. I'm John Strong, joining you for our halftime report. Let's start you off, as we always do, with our Miller Lite USL Division I scoreboard brought to you by Miller Lite. Good call. Last night, we'll go back to Friday night, the other two games going on when Portland beat California that night. Montreal getting the win over Carolina on an Antonio Ribeiro goal in the 84th minute. Puerto Rico beating Charleston 3-1. Noel Fabrice with two goals in that one. Last night, Atlanta, you know, this team, they're in the middle of the table, but they can put up some serious goals. 4-1, the win over Rochester. Dan Antonio, former Portland Timber, with a goal and an assist in that one. The big upset last night, Miami, a 2-1 win over Vancouver up at Swan Guard Stadium. Jason Jordan, a goal in the third minute for Vancouver in front of a standing room only crowd, but in the end, Miami two second half goals and they get the win. Vancouver, their second home loss in their last three. They had won 10 straight at home before the beginning of that streak. And really keep in mind, too, they went a month between home games, Vancouver, as their stadium was being used for the Under-20 World Cup. So the Whitecaps are searching for some answers, and their next game is going to be Thursday against Portland. That should be very, very interesting. Two other results from today. We'll tell you first about the one that didn't matter, but the one that looked more entertaining. Puerto Rico beats Charleston 4-3 at home. Puerto Rico got the winning goal in the 59th. Pretty early, all the goals. Byron Alvarez getting a goal, the former Portland Timber, as Puerto Rico get that win. The other big one, though, is it concerns the Portland Timbers and really everyone across the league. Minnesota 3, Montreal 0. Minnesota, who came in tied for last place in the league at the start of the day, they get the win over Montreal 3-0. Montreal, who were tied for second, three goals, two in the first half, one in the second in Minnesota, and the points go to the Thunder. So here's what the standings look like right now in the USL First Division. Seattle still in first place, 28 points right now. One ahead of that four-team group, Portland, Vancouver, Montreal, and Rochester. Vancouver and Montreal spinning their wheels right now with those last two wins. Timbers, with a draw tonight, would move into a tie with Seattle for first place in the league with a win, would have it to themselves. Atlanta down in sixth place. Puerto Rico are now in seventh. They've leapt ahead of both Charleston and Miami, who are now tied for eighth. Carolina, Minnesota, and California rounding out the bottom of the table. The goal-scoring leader in the USL First Division remains Vancouver's Eduardo Sabrango. He is now tied, though, with Byron Alvarez of the Charleston Battery, getting his seventh goal of the season today. Assist leader is still Dan Antoniak, 8 assists, twice as many as anyone else. The second place all have 4 assists each. Andrew Greger with 3 had he been given the assist on that goal. Would have been a tie for second, but as such, no. One other note from the USL, from the W League, a big game last night.
And a penalty kick has been awarded to Portland. Jordan again in the mix. He draws so much attention with his activity in the box. And Andrew Gregor, the Timbers captain, will bop the ball and prepare for the PK. Left-footed shot for Gregor. Shot. And he scores! Inside the right post, 1-0 Timbers in the 11th minute. This time the ball spotted a mere 26 yards out. Gregor hits it with the left foot. Header in front, shot, score! 2-0 Timbers, it's Brian Jordan! Gregor now with 15 points on the year. Here's a chance and another score for the Timbers. They go up 3-0. This time it's Cameron Knowles. A 20th minute goal.
Now ricochet. Ball played forward. Dangerous. Very dangerous. Portland winning the ball. Lights it in. Oh, just past the forward far post.
Second half. Coming in.
Uh-oh, here we go. Oh, dangerous.
Gerald now. Ball in the middle.
Hansen, nice touch. Munoz, open. Shot over the...
He wasn't dressed in uniform that day. He was just in street clothes.
Oh, nice shot. Oh! Nicely driven there.
Yano Diaz. Diaz. Down the far side. Sean Frazier up top has it knocked away, as we see with Douglas. Ball taken down to the end line. Switched in front. Frazier dangerous. A header. When in close, it goes over the ball.
Start to his pace. When he gets going, he just flashes by people.
Great back heel by Gregor in the box. Bagley centers up in front, shot, and it's over the bar. Josh Wicks comes out, the throw flying, picks it up. I was calling him Dr. J on the plane yesterday.
You know, Frazier does his job well. He hangs right on the edge of that back line.
Knowles crushes it downfield, and it's headed over the line. The left-footed player will swing this one to the inside of his left boot. Ricochets in, header by Higgins, follow up, and it's save made by Fenelon. Justin Thompson has it stripped away. Here's a breakaway for Sean Frazier. Frazier, a shot off the upper V, rebound, and what a stop by Leonard Griffin. Frazier nearly had not one but two chances. Running over is Cameron Knowles to clear it down. Up for Brian Jordan. Jordan. Marked by two men. Nice little move. Gets around and then taken down. That'll be a foul.
Well, Gregor's had a bit of trouble getting into the game. We've seen a couple good touches from him. And, of course, he takes the free kicks and everything. But
Miami FC with a steal. Good chance here as they play Frazier through. Frazier, a shot near post, saved by Wicks. Trying to use that left boot. Double team comes from Polito. Higg nearly falls down, somehow dribbles it around, whips across in, and it's right at Fenelon, the keeper. Miami FC, Bagley, a quick throw in for Gregor. Gregor loads up the left foot, in front, tipped, and it's pushed away by Fenelon. Ball kept alive by Higg, though. Higg plays it in. Jordan shot, and a save by Fenelon. Now Griffin in the middle. Higg, left-footed blast from distance. Fenelon may have juggled or... You can reach us on the instant messenger. Timbers Radio is our screen name. Here's Andrew Gregor to the back post and colliding with the keeper, Fenelon. Not many fouls in the first half. No cards to this point. And it will remain that way. On the first move of the night for Portland. Gregor throws the ball in. Fenelon wisely knocks it out. It'll give up another down. That was Kiki Lara. Miami encounter, looking for the speedy Frazier. Wicks is out of goal. Chance here for Vasquez, and he knocks it wide. They'll bend it from left to right. Header is up. Point blank saved by Fenelon. The chance of the match for Portland. Ball flicked forward by Harrington. Higg, a left-footed blast, and it goes just wide. Hands. Section 107. Gregor on the restart. Header, Olam, shot, score! They've done it again! Lawrence Olam, 1-0 Timbers.
this time they get it on frame with the header. Andrew Gregor taking it from about half field just inside Miami's part. Whips it in. Nice long ball. Fenelong doesn't come out. Olam just lobs it right over his head or puts it away into the near post. Portland had pretty much filled the box. There's only a couple players outside. Wonderful finish by Lawrence.
And we are at PGE Park in Portland, where the hometown Timbers, and you see the Timbers Army there, getting ready to take on the California Victory.
I had the first shot.
And here's a chance for Portland right away. There's a shot and stopped by Reed as Chris Bagley got in behind the California defense. And the first real good chance of the game.
Ball is blading nicely over the top. It's a good shot. Goalkeeper makes it.
And there is Fahrenheit 107, Timbers Army.
Aguilar stepping up, as John mentioned. Really pressing up forward. Back post for Morales. Morales sends one back top of the box. A shot and a save by Wicks. That was a tougher save than it appeared to be.
Good shot, and the goalkeeper did an incredibly good job here. And the player is open on the edge of the penalty area.
North American Soccer League. And the Timbers used to play here.
Portland, chance for Higgins. Still has the ball at his feet, lays it off. Here's a shot through. What a save by Reed, the follow-up, and it's deflected wide. Chris Bagley is snake bit. He got the shot off, and Reed made one of the best saves we've seen all season.
Well, it's a left footer that deflects it just wide.
See this again. It's good disguise. Actually, a deflection.
And the Portland crowd asking Timber Jim, has he got wood? Well, lots of creative signs.
Over the top for Jordan. Jordan runs onto it, heads it down to himself. He's by the D, left-footed shot. It goes just wide. Here's a corner directly at Josh Wicks. He fields it easily. Kind of surprised him.
Yeah, it's a disappointing end there. You've got Bondi's forward, and you don't really get anything dangerous out of it. You play it right to the goalkeeper, and now you've got a counter chance the other way.
Here's Scott Thompson. Jordan in front. Shot. Score! BJ puts the Timbers up 1-0 off a great run from Scott Thompson. 1-0 Timbers in the 52nd minute. Kiki Lara across the middle. Here's Haig. Haig, a left-footed shot. Oh, he wants that back. Olam clears it down. This has got to be it. It is. The Timbers have shut out the California Victory for the fourth consecutive time in 2007. They have run their shutout streak to four straight matches in league play, and Portland is now a point out of first place. Could they go worse than first?
What's up? This is Leonard Griffin with the Portland Timbers.
Griffin steps into one, right foot shot, score! Frazier, a shot off the upper B, rebound, and what a stop by Leonard Griffin.
And you're watching the Portland Timbers on USL Live.
We are back at PG Park in Portland, where our score is 1-1 between the California Victory and the Portland Timbers. Looks like Sean Higgins will come on for the Timbers in the midfield as a substitution here to start the second half. Gregor still with the jersey on, so he will remain out there. Podol as well. Kiki Lara. And it looks like Kremelmeyer will be the one that will take a seat for the rest of this one. Replaced in the lineup by Sean Higgins. Kremelmeyer picking up an assist on Cameron Knoll's goal, which tied the match in the 32nd minute off a free kick from Gregor. The official score sheet had the assist credited to Gregor, but after looking at the tape, Blake Tim, the official scorer, was convinced that yes, indeed, Luke Kremelmeyer got ahead on the ball and
deserved the assist. And Kremelmeyer is still out there, so we'll have to see who Higgins is taking the spot of. Bagley is off.
Yeah, Bagley. Well, you know, maybe that's what the Timbers were lacking in the first half. They didn't seem quite themselves from Friday night as far as possessing in the middle. That's not necessarily Higgins' job. He's kind of more of a spark plug to move forward and create chances, not really holding the ball. But, you know, keep in mind that with Bagley off, even though Jordan's a leaper, you've lost your target height up front. So it's going to, again, unless you get Jordan leaping up, it's going to have to be on the carpet here offensively for Portland. So we'll see what kind of an effect that has. Gavin, I'm sure, just trying to inject some life in his attack, which just didn't quite have that same pop that it did on Friday night.
Bagley's touch appeared to be a bit off tonight as well. His first couple of touches on the ball didn't seem to have it tonight. That's not unusual that you lose it here and then. We're underway. Timbers now moving left to right across your internet browser for those of you listening on PortlandTimbers.com. For those of you watching on USL Live, you're watching it unfold in front of you. Here in the 46th minute, quick early foul on Portland and a restart for California. Up on the right wing. Just one field player remains on the bench for the victory. Timbers with an assortment of players left, if needed in this one. Schwartz goes on a run in the box. It's through, tipped in front. Wide open chance by the victory, and they missed it. Timbers struggling to clear and finally do. Dangerous there. That should have been a goal, John.
It should be 2-1 California right now. Timbers unable to clear, just looking completely disorganized on defense. And even when they got their chance to clear, they didn't. So California there going to feel very hard done by. They weren't able to knock that in and take a 2-1 lead. By the way, one program note we do want to say for those of you watching on USL Live, that match next Thursday against Vancouver is going to be broadcast on TV here in the Portland area. We're pretty certain that they will be able to give us a feed, and that'll be what you see on USL Live. So it shouldn't make any difference to you, but just in case, if for some reason something comes up this week and you go to USL Live, you see nothing, go to PortlandTimbers.com. That's where you can always find our live free audio webcast at PortlandTimbers.com.
47th minute, 1-1 the score. California should be enjoying a 2-1 lead now, but when you're a last-place team, those are the types of things that happen to you.
Well, for the Timbers, they should feel lucky and should have a little bit of renewed energy to try to go up and make sure they take advantage of that luck that they're not down 2-1.
Well-struck free kick by Sanchez on that play, but Portland, as you mentioned, just not organized at all in the back. Epite appeared to be offside. Ball kept alive. Weak volley shot goes wide. Some jeers for Josh Hansen from the Timbers Army, and Josh Wicks will retrieve the ball and now spot it for a goal kick.
I tell you, we've only played, 2 minutes here in the second half, but the Timbers just look lifeless right now. It's not like California is really buzzing around, but they certainly look the more likely team to go and win tonight. And this is kind of proving out what I was afraid of. What we talked about in the open was California was going to be the very desperate team tonight, and the Timbers maybe a bit complacent, either because they thought they were just going to go and win again or because they're tired of having to play this team. Full credit to California. They've come out tonight. They've been the better team. Certainly room for improvement, but they're certainly also going to feel unlucky that they're not in the lead right now.
Another foul called against Portland. Restart by California on the defensive side, their defensive side of the middle third. Munoz in the middle. Up for Hansen. Hansen lays it off. Aguilar, the right back, plays it down the line. Victory linking some passes together here. This is something Portland really hasn't done at all tonight. Sanchez works it free for Epite. Five different players touch the ball as they move from one side of the field to the next. Sanchez, a poor touch, but it banks off Poto right to Casillas. Casillas getting around Kremelmeyer, puts it into space. Bianchi just allowed to walk through, has a man, it's Chandler, and his shot is high. Offside flag came down anyway. So Wicks will restart it here in the 49th minute of a 1-1 match. Long ball over the top, Kremelmeyer tried to head it on for Make that Jordan, rather, for Higgins.
He got it in the chin, actually. He got, seemed to be knocked backwards by it.
Scott Thompson down the line. Hook up with Gregory. He got a touch on it, but it goes over the touch line, so that sets up a throw for California deep in their defensive third. 50th minute. Whistle.
Another foul on Gregor there, and again, remember, he's still got that yellow card. He's still, I think, walking a tightrope with this referee.
Sanchez clears it all the way over to the far side of the field. Now gets it back. Sanchez pushing forward. Long left-footed shot, easily fielded by Wicks.
Well, and again, you've got the California player there. Sanchez, I think it was. And he takes the shot from distance, but he's got three teammates with him in that attacking third. And he's not even looking to use them. He's just looking to take the shot. And again, as we've been saying, particularly Friday night, if you shoot from distance against Josh Wicks, unless you get that wacky deflection like in the first half, or unless it's just a perfect shot, he's going to make that save.
Long run for Yuri Morales. Finally gives it up. Chance in front. Epite. Poor touch. He was offside anyway.
Very, very close decision there. As Cameron Knowles stepping up right at the last second. I'm actually a little surprised to see the flag up. Josh Wicks did a good job alertly off his line there to close it down anyway. But California, they're creating chances, looking very dangerous here. Certainly have been the better team in the first 5 minutes of the second half, and the Timbers really need to tighten things up defensively, giving California a lot of space and time on the ball.
California out shooting Portland 6-2 in this one.
Portland Timbers do not look like a team tonight that is ready to take first place in the league.
Down the near side, Krammelmeyer tries to center for Jordan, stepping up. Lara was there. Now Podol in front. Jordan collides with Reed. The ball is loose, and we'll have a offside call anyway against Portland.
I wonder, had it not been offside, would they have let that go as Jordan, he was looking for the ball, but he definitely had his arm up there to try to interfere with Reed, the goalkeeper, and prevent him from collecting the ball cleanly.
The referee
may feel kind of bailed out by his linesman there that he didn't have to make that decision.
Cameron Knowles steps in front, takes the possession away for Portland. Now Scott Thompson, who's had a rough match tonight, hasn't really been involved a whole lot, and his touch also off like Bagley was. Sanchez gets it stuck on his foot, picked away by Krammelmeyer, but he turns it right back.
This match is devolving right now.
Giving it to Schwartz, who gives it to Epite.
Just getting really, really ugly in the middle.
Epite for Bianchi. Bianchi was credited with that first goal, although it appeared to deflect off of Chandler.
You know, the interesting thing, we look at the players right now. They're within about, I don't know, 40 yards of each other down the pitch, and they're not really using much width. They're playing in just a small box in the field. Anya from Southeast Portland. I think we're pronouncing that right. I don't know. Thanks for tuning in.
Timbers Radio is our screen name at the AOL Instant Messenger. You can always check in with us during the broadcast. Epite in the center circle. Able to find Bianchi. Bianchi for Munoz. It's like a passing drill here by California. Let's see what they do in the final third. Nothing. That's been their story throughout this series with Portland. Schwartz appeared to foul Jordan, but they're going to call Brian Jordan this time. They got tangled up with one another.
Well, I mean, the referee there feeling that Jordan kind of pushed the defender. I think the contact was going both ways, and it was best just to not call it. But
especially considering how far out the referee was from that play. He did not have a good look at it. Long shot in on Wicks. California is wasting their chances now. They're they're able to possess the ball in the middle of the park, something they haven't been able to do at all in this series this season. They're not making the most of it right now. Jordan sandwiched by two players, knocked down.
Is that going to be a red
card?
Yep.
And it's a red card. Guess what? California back to their old tricks.
That's a straight red.
Straight red. Sanchez, I believe, will get it. Now Podol gets in his face. Primo Meyer, who's definitely not a bully in any sense, he's even in there.
I don't know if that's really a red card. Sanchez, I mean, he planted his studs right in Brian Jordan's midsection. But it was a bouncing ball. Jordan had to leap up, try to control it off his chest and bring it down. It was still bouncing up in the air. And Sanchez was trying to play it. I think what the referee is going to rule there is he just kind of, you know, lunged out with his foot recklessly, and that oftentimes can be a red card, particularly when he did hit Jordan in the midsection there. I still think it's a harsh decision, but it's one the Timbers have to take advantage of. Let's recall the game against Carolina here earlier this year. They go up 10 men late in the first half, never able to take advantage of finishing 0-0. Portland very much needs to get a goal out of this, take this opportunity, turn it to 3 points.
Well, Sanchez picking up his first yellow, or first red of the season. Came in second on the team, though, with 5 yellow cards. He's already had to sit one match, and he'll have to sit another one after this. So the Timbers, here in the 56th minute, will now be up a man, you would think, for the remainder of this match. They can keep their composure. Gregor with an outstanding free kick chance. Look for him to put this on direct. The shot right into the wall. It deflects out. Scott Thompson will gather.
And again, that wall is definitely not 10 yards away.
That's been the case for both teams tonight.
Which is down to the referee not being disciplined enough to make sure that wall stays there and give a yellow card if necessary.
Here's Munoz over the top. Long run for Chandler. Wicks, though, at the top of the penalty area. Scoops it up. California's only chance likely will be on the counter for the rest of this one as they are down a man. Timbers move it through the middle. Lara mishits the last linking pass intended for Sean Higgins, and now it comes free for Cameron Knowles.
I have to ask cynically if this game is going to finish 11-10 or maybe there's one more red card left to go.
Here's Kramelmeyer for Podol. Podol back for Kramelmeyer. All of a sudden, with just one man less for California, the Timbers have found their passing. Here's Higgins.
Oh,
Kramelmeyer goes down. It should have been advantage. Another card comes out. Kramelmeyer is slow to get up. Schwartz, I believe.
That was Schwartz who got the card. They're taking down Kramelmeyer at the edge of the box. But again, it was a first touch in. Alora's running in. Second time we've seen that one to each team with a referee whistle it dead. You can play advantage, and then if it's necessary, you can come back and give the yellow card later, actually. You see it every once in a while. It doesn't have to be given right then.
And Higgins was in.
Yeah, I really think the referee needs to let that play go.
Chandler is off. And Chuck Kemp comes on, and Kemp can be dangerous because of his speed. Not a large man in stature, but very, very, very fast. Once again, Gregor will have the free kick, and once again, we're just hoping the referee would give the Timbers 10 yards, but it's once again, it's 7 yards that time. And the reason that we know this is because you can still see the faded American football lines on this turf.
Which should make his job easier.
Yeah, it should make his job very easy.
To say, here's the line, don't go forward.
They're 5-yard increments, and that one was 7 yards. So Gregor, who should have been able to shoot at goal, had no chance there. 59th minute.
But I think it's worth pointing out before everyone thinks we're giant homers. The problem for the referee that going both ways tonight.
3-v-2 if they hurry. Here's Brian Jordan, top of the box. Loses the handle. And Jordan that time, we've seen it a couple times this year where he struggles in the final third when he has men with him. But a rookie will do that. Timbers still with possession. Gregor, great ball for Scott Thompson. To the back post, too much on it though. I don't know if Jordan just didn't have enough energy left to go up on that one. But
I think that ball sliced a little bit too from Thompson. Better for Portland though. They, as you said, Andy, they get that red card. It's kind of you know, liven them up a little bit. And you see the Timbers have their bench clear, everyone getting loose now on the far side. I think they know. I mean, it would have been disappointing enough anyway to come in and not get 3 points, given that you've done it four times before. Particularly that you're going to be playing the final half hour plus of this game with an extra man, assuming no one has anything stupid.
We're in the 60th minute. And I think the other thing, John, is it actually puts some more pressure back on Portland, because now they're expected to score that second goal.
And it's easy to get complacent. That's what we saw in the Carolina game when they didn't get that goal, is Gavin Wilkinson said afterwards it was largely because they just got kind of complacent. They figured it was going to come, and then no one was willing to step up and make the plays to make it happen.
1-1 the score. The Timbers have never led in this one. Ricardo Sanchez getting sent off here in the second half for a red card. So Portland, a man up if you're just tuning in.
But again, for the Timbers to get 3 points tonight, to be by themselves in first place ahead of that game with Vancouver on Thursday. Other teams play. Montreal plays it in the next few days, so they wouldn't necessarily be by themselves once the game started Thursday. But just for that psychologically to set up what's already going to be a great match, okay. Very important.
Another free kick. Let's measure it off. Currently, Epete is 5 yards away. That is not an exaggeration. Great ball to the back post. Reed comes out and crushes a Portland player who is down. I think that's Lee Mercer.
I think it's Lee, too. Yeah, he went up. Same thing as Kremelmeyer did on the goal, trying to get to that ball first, and just got two fists in the back of his head.
You can't really blame Reed on that. I mean, he's just going all out.
Absolutely. But both players, they're going for the ball. That's what happens. And those goalkeepers have gloves, but I guarantee you there's no real padding. It's pretty much straight knuckle there to the back of the head. But Limo's a tough kid.
He's up. Lee has seen his playing time shrink this year, so he's going to be extra motivated to get back up. California on their back line with it. 1-1 in the 62nd minute. Timbers looking to take advantage of the red card to Sanchez. This is only the second time California has advanced it past the center line since that card almost 10 minutes ago. Epete down the near side, has a man with him. It's Morales. It's picked away by Scott Thompson. Now Knowles. Victory back with possession. Munoz. Morales. Morales taking down Poeltl. Foul call. Restart for Wicks and the Timbers. 62nd minute. Cooling off a bit here at PG Park. Kind of a muggy start, but that type of weather isn't the norm here in the Pacific Northwest, so it's only a matter of time before the traditional humidity level returns, and it feels like it has right now. Very comfortable here. California, Josh Hansen. Miss hits it. Easy one hop for Josh Wicks, who comes down with it.
Yeah, we mentioned that the Timbers tonight snapping that scoreless streak at 382 minutes. Twice they've gone four consecutive clean sheets. Right now in MLS, Houston and Toronto tied. Houston has now set the record for most minutes without giving up a goal in MLS history. They've had shutouts their last seven games, and they're 5 minutes away from going eight straight shutouts. It's a lot harder to keep a team from scoring on MLS, I think it's fair to say, than here in USL1. So it kind of puts in perspective how impressive what Houston is doing, but also what the Timbers have been doing, how hard it is just to get four straight.
64th minute. Poor throw by the Timbers was intercepted by California, and now another restart coming for California. Chuck Kim having a go at Mr. Hedajet, the referee. Maybe wanting more than just a foul. Munoz will restart. Low liner in the box, headed out nicely by Tom Poeltl. Poeltl seeing his first action since being injured at California. That took place in the first meeting in the Bay back on June 28th.
Man, Poeltl, such an important player to this team. Hard-nosed defensive midfielder, can just crack some heads in there, really get involved. Short in stature, but he can acquit himself fair enough in the air. And also, at times, can be a pretty decent passer. He's certainly more of a defender than an attacking player, but you love to see him back on the field making good things happen.
Leonard Griffin, some skill. Hooked up with Kremelmeyer. David Higgs going to check on for the Timbers here in a moment. Griffin gets it free for Gregor. Gregor looking for Kremelmeyer. Stripped away. Victory. Just dump it down. Californian down a man in a draw situation on the road. Will likely not take any chances from this point forward if they can help themselves.
Yeah, they'll definitely sit back here. It's going to make the Timbers' job quite a bit harder.
Griffin. Top fly to center. Nearly brought down by Jordan. Cameron Knowles now steps up. Once again, it's cleared over the center line by California, intercepted by the Timbers. Kiki Lara. Lara down the flank looking for Gregor. Knocked away. It'll be a throw for Portland. 66th minute. Timbers up a man in a tie match. 1-1. They go in for Leonard Griffin. Griffin draws another throw.
I wonder who you take off for Hager.
Hague's got the penny off.
You'd hate to take Brian Jordan off. We've already discussed the merits for taking Gregor off, maybe, but the negatives as well. Kremelmeyer, maybe, he's done good things tonight.
I think it's either going to be Brian Jordan or Kiki Lara that's going to come off. Here's Poeltl working to get it free for Jordan, and that's unlucky. Offside, just barely. 67th minute. It is going to be Brian Jordan. No, Kremelmeyer. Saw the 20, what I thought was a 26. It's the 25 for Hague. So Kremelmeyer comes up, and I don't think that's a slam against him, John. Luke seems to really have difficulty the day after playing on this surface. It really affects him, even though he's kind of a, you know, he's not a big guy, so he doesn't have the pounding of, say, a Knowles or a Thompson, but.
I thought it was a very good 67 minutes from Luke. He was involved creating that goal with a heads-up play. Wasn't quite as dangerous coming down the wing as I would have hoped, but, you know, given that he just hasn't played a whole lot of late, it's solid enough.
And Hague has shown he can finish, and here he is. David Hague cuts it back, left foot shot, score! You saw it coming from 40 yards away when he first touched the ball with real estate in front of him. You just knew. And the crafty vet fakes the right-footed shot, pulls it back to the left, loses the defender, and buries it. 2-1 Timbers in the 68th minute.
What a classy finish there from Hague. Bit of an angle to the right as he came in. Eric Reed did a good job there, but what he did is he cut it back around the defender, and he set and he waited, and he waited for the goalkeeper to come in. Reed was shading off to the far post to the right there. He just sat and he sat and he sat there with the left bottom corner near post. Didn't get freaked out by the chance, took his time, put it in. And a very important goal.
And that was the other part of his finish. You know, you can maybe credit some of that to the 89th minute goal he had at California, to have the confidence to go short side there. He went near post, not as much room necessarily. But, you know, it was obviously the solid decision. Taylor in.
Tom Taylor just coming on there in the goal for Kiki Lara.
Now California will start to take some risks.
I like to see Taylor in. He's a good player in possession. He's got some height. He can be good in the air.
Timbers spreading it around this year, although they give up a corner Right after the goal here, California allowed to come in. Four corner kick fielded by Josh Wicks at the back post, and he'll set the ball down. Clear it out, looking for Jordan. Jordan able to settle momentarily. Now it's knocked away by the Victory. Aguilar clearing it. Epite sort of out of position on the back line. Now he comes up through the middle. For David Haig, that's his second goal of the year. And in just over 310 minutes, Haig now with two goals and one assist. That's very impressive. 5 points in 300 minutes. He's taken 11 shots, scored twice. And now, you know, you talk about spreading things around. Gavin Wilkinson saying at the outset of this season, before the first game was played, that goals were going to have to come from all over the place. Well, Gregor may have six, but you look down the line. Now Knowles with two, Griffin with two, Haig with two, Jordan with four. A goal for Kremelmeyer, Dombrowski, Olam. Epite is out. And the final field player on the bench comes in for California. If I'm seeing things correctly.
He's listed as a goalkeeper.
Yeah, that's, and that is Jackie Beck. So, I mean, this is what it's come to for California. They only bring 14 players to the match tonight. They lose one by red card. And now they're forced to bring their backup goalkeeper into the match as a field player. Oh, gosh. I was going to say they don't have anybody left because they've already used Munoz and Kim. Well, here he is.
Quick note, Andrew Gregor with that assist is fourth of the year, tied for second in the league, and he's now all alone second in the league in points with 16.
Jackie Beck in the wall. Munoz, dangerous free kick chance. Hits somebody in front. Jackie Beck tries to track it down. Leonard Griffin gets tangled up with Hansen. Leonard is hopping over. And he's going to have to go down here. And that might, hopefully that's just a sell on Leonard's part to say, hey, it was an equal foul between me and Hansen, because Hansen went down and was really trying to beg for some sort of card in the box there, or foul in the box.
You know, I'll say this. That kid looks like a goalkeeper out there. I mean, he's got kind of a big frame.
Exactly.
He doesn't seem entirely sure what he should be doing or where he should be going.
Yeah.
But you watch. I mean, if he gets a chance, he may score a goal, and then we'll be eating our words. So.
And he's playing up top, too. Timber's got to tighten up here. They're letting California dribble it into harm's way. Here's a center in front. He almost had a chance, but offside comes down.
I think that ball crossed the line there right at the end, it looked like. Just getting a little bit out of control. That's a tough part of this pitch, is you're dribbling that ball and it just rolls so quickly on you that it can be hard to keep it in play there.
73rd minute, the Timbers about 17 minutes away from picking up 15 points against the California Victory. If they do, they'll have 30 points on the season. So half of their points will have come against California. I couldn't agree with you more, though, about Jackie Beck, John. He stands out like an absolute sore thumb. Sure, he's wearing the same uniform as the rest of the guys.
Which is surprising. You wouldn't think they would have given him a normal field player's uniform, except, I guess, preparing for this kind of circumstance.
Look at that. He lays it off nicely. Down the near side, Kim. Lots of speed. Down by the end line. Center's in front. Jackie Beck's there, but can't get a shot off.
Here comes Portland on a counterattack. This could be very dangerous.
We've got to hurry. Gregor had it on his right foot. Still does. Plays it through. Oh, my goodness.
Well, California defense are doing a good job there. They're really getting organized, and I think they know that if it's a foot race, they're going to lose. And so they're just making sure to really pay attention, step up right at the last second.
That was a good call. Just Gregor hanging on a second too long. I don't think he's completely comfortable with the ball on his right foot there. 74th minute. I think Portland really would like that third goal, though.
Absolutely.
John.
Well, let's not forget. I mean, California's playing with 10, and they're pushing forward. So they're spectacularly exposed in the back here to the counterattack. They're trying to leave three back instead of two. But you're right. This is Still very close. I'd love to get a third.
Here's one over the top. Here's a chance. Left for the shot. Score! He's done it again. David Hay from Josh Wicks. Second assist on the season for Wicks. Third goal of the year for Hay. We're going to just keep talking, John. Every time we talk about something, it happens. Hay comes on. We talk him up like he's the man for the job, and boom, he scores the go-ahead.
And that was a nice finish. Bouncing ball, and he just hit it low and hard. Bottom right-hand corner past the goalkeeper. Hard to corral that ball. So easy to just send it a mile over the crossbar when it's bouncing like that. But a classy finish again. Great finisher, this kid. Great pickup to have him here on the Timbers. And now Timbers, I'm sure, feeling a lot better up 3-1 with 15 minutes to go. And, you know, could there be more?
Ryan Jordan goes down. Now is a chance, I think, you get some of these guys off the pitch for Portland, just in case California loses their cool. Gregor, Jordan. I think we're going to see Tom Taylor come on. We might even see Meisner get a shot at some USL One playing time after playing in a couple of friendlies this year. Wicks comes on. Looking back, John, the missed opportunity by California early in this half. Right at the outset of the half, really. They should have had a 2-1 lead. They absolutely blew a wide open chance.
Well, there's been more than one. They've definitely had their chances. You know, and even it's fair to say, I think after the red card, they've had their chances, where the Timbers have really struggled defensively. And yeah, they're going to feel very frustrated here, because this is certainly a match. You know, we said a couple times they should have been up 2-1. Plus the red card, which I'm still not entirely sure was really a red card. But to be down 3-1 now, there's not really any coming back from this.
76th minute, 3-1 Portland. The Timbers matching their highest goal output in a single game this year. They scored three in a 3-0 victory at California. They also scored three in the season opener, a 3-1 win against Puerto Rico. And let's not forget, the lone goal that they allowed tonight was a fluke. California certainly should have converted on another chance, but the one that they scored, they really lucked out on. 77th minute.
And, of course, David Hay, two goals tonight. The last Timber to get two goals in a match, that was Andrew Gregor, of course, in the opener. It really doesn't happen too often that a Timber scores multiple goals this year. You know, you get to go back to 2004 for times when players would regularly do that.
Luke Harrington with a big smile on his face. Waiting for Brian Jordan, the high five, and they'll swap spots. Brian Jordan, take the rest of the game off. Well, Bagley's all right. He never did rejoin the team over on the bench on the far side.
Well, it's not a huge turnaround Sunday to Thursday for that next match, let's keep in mind. But unless something really screwy here happens in the end, Timbers will be feeling very good about themselves ahead of that one.
Gregor plays it downfield. Eggs in there. This will be a throw for California. 4,813 tonight here at PGE Park. David Higgs going to need some help carrying those two big chunks of the victory log he is going to have to lug out of here after the match tonight. Gregor still out there. Gets tangled up. Still with possession. Now off for Scott Thompson. Thompson, you get a whistle and a foul against Casillas for bothering Gregor. Seventy-ninth minute. Meisner's going to come on. And Leonard Griffin's going to get the rest of the night off. Bagley is down on the near side with some of the other Timbers who are not in uniform tonight. Well, he appears to be all right. So the back line is Meisner, Morrison, Knowles, and Scott Thompson from left to right. 80th minute, 3-1 Portland. They've broken it open here in the second half. They've scored three unanswered in the match, all told. Tom Taylor also on. Here's Haig looking for the hat trick. Oh. And he shoots this one high and wide.
I was just going to say, as you said, when we talk about things, they tend to happen. So I'll say this now. The last David Haig, two goals right now. The last Timber to get a hat trick was Dan Antoniak, now of Atlanta, in the second to last regular season match of 2005. September 8, 2005, Dizzy with three goals and a 6-1 win over Atlanta. So, we'll test if we really have what kind of powers we do have up here, I guess. Now that we've mentioned it.
You know, Haig is just flying around, walking on air out there. He's not even breathing. He's not going to wear down. 10 minutes to go. Here's Jack Ubeck, the keeper, who is playing one of the forward spots now for California, calling for the ball. He's got it. And he dribbles it out to midfield. Now off to the near side, Chuck Kim, avoiding a tackle from Scott Thompson. Then he turns it over, gives it right to Kodal. Kodal for Gregor. Gregor looking for Haig. Getting back defensively is Aguilar. California back with possession, looking for Jack Ubeck. He gets tangled with Knowles. Timbers look to counter quickly. Haig dribbles around a couple of tackles, lays it off behind Harrington. He wanted Luke to go to the right. Luke went left.
Well, and Gregor really upset because as Haig went across from left to right across the field, the three orange shirts that were marking him came with him. So Gregor was in acres of space on the left, had both his arms up waving, hoping for the ball. By the way, last time the Timbers scored more than three goals in a match, that aforementioned 6-1 win against Atlanta back in 2005.
Kim in the middle of Bianchi. Munoz. I'm going to kind of miss California because I no longer have to look at any sort of roster. You know, if I get stuck on a number. Know these guys as well as Portland at this point. Know where they play on the field.
Well, but you've got Vancouver coming in. I think it's fair to say we know one or two of those guys. So, should be too bad.
82nd minute. With a win tonight, the Timbers will be in first place in the first division all by themselves. 2 points clear of Seattle. However, they'll only be 3 points clear of three other squads. So, still very tight at the top. Wicks with a clearance. Harrington, beautiful header off for Haig. Haig left side. Gregor with the entry ball, knotted down. California cleared it, but Thompson, Scott Thompson, steps up and strips him away. Dribbles it around Kim. Gregor at the top, takes it to the near post, and it's cleared away. It'll be a throw for Portland.
And to finish the thought there, Montreal Wednesday night plays at Minnesota again, so the Timbers could be back in second player, being a tie for first, I guess I should say, by the time that Vancouver game rolls around. I'll put that again, who knows.
Top of the box, Podol lays it off Gregor. Gregor just didn't get enough lift on that, looking for Haig at the back post. 83rd minute, 3-1 Portland. Long run down the far side for Morales. Kodal knocks it away. Jurie will take a throw right in front of his former bench. Bianchi plays it through. Hansen in the box. Cuts it across, but there's Scott Thompson to poke it away. California. Over the end line, goal kick coming for Wicks.
So I'm curious here. Should the Timbers be sending a thank you card of some type to that former Virginia Beach owner who backed out on the eve of the season, or what's the protocol for that?
Yeah, that was what really set this schedule up. They were already going to play California a bunch of times, but certainly not five times and certainly not three consecutive matches. The victory can take a small victory away tonight, the fact that they did score a goal against Portland.
Well, they were the better team for large stretches, and they just a little bit of bad luck to not be able to capitalize on a couple of good chances, and then, of course, the red card. And it's a fifth consecutive loss to this Timbers team.
Timbers have outscored California now 10-1 in these five matches. Kim for Jack Ubeck. Jack Ubeck for Hanson. Hodel. Long run for Harrington down the near side. Able to keep it in, though. Crowd upset. It was the right call. It just took the linesman an awful long time to put the flag up. But he made the proper call. Bianchi for Kim. Whistle and a foul on Podol. Really surprised that Andrew Gregor is still on the pitch for Portland, carrying that yellow card with him. Here's Bianchi. Morrison stepped up, cleared it. Taken back by Schwartz. Hanson nods it in. Chance for California. Wicks is out. But Munoz cannot corral it. Now Kim at the top of the box. His right-footed shot. The keeper, Jack Ubeck, is offside. Tries to dribble Wicks, and he smothers it anyway. Didn't need to.
What a great flick-in header, though, to put Munoz through, and then just an atrocious first touch to take him too wide. Otherwise, he should have really been planting that in because he beat Wicks and got around him. He just went so far wide that he couldn't get anything out of it. But yeah, that was a very nice attack. We've seen a number of those tonight from California. They're at the bottom of the standings, not for a lack of talent, just a lack of consistency, I think.
Higgins plays it near side for Gregor. Gregor tries to dribble his man, has it taken away by Casillas. Casillas down by the corner flag, draws a throw. I was watching Casillas during pre-match warm-ups. He could make a YouTube video of himself dribbling and volleying the ball, juggling. Just all sorts of skill. Showing some off there by drawing the throw against Gregor. 87th minute. Timbers a couple minutes away from being in first place. From worst to first.
And first place with matches at hand.
Here's Haig looking for the triple threat. Shot, score! He's got it. The hat trick for Haig. 88th minute, 4-1 Timbers. Their biggest offensive output of the season. And a natural hat trick for David Haig. Three in a row.
And I really, really hate to have to say this. I don't think that should have been a goal. That ball was played in, and Haig, with just a really, I felt, obvious push on Chuck Kemp, the defender, just extending his arm completely to push him off there and get the shot off, and Kemp immediately upset, arguing the call. Good on Haig. Whistle never went. It was a great finish. He's got his hat trick, and he certainly worked hard enough for it, but I definitely think he got away with one there.
Let's talk about the finish. He was 1v1 essentially, but had to chip the keeper from close range. So no margin of error for Haig there, and he was able to flip it over the top and bag the natural hat trick. Most goals since Atlanta in September of 05 for the Portland Timbers. Also here at home. That was a 6-1 win that night. 89th minute. California down a man. They've got a goalkeeper playing in the field. And a the wheels have come off completely. Higgins is checking on the replay to try to see who had the assist. Higgins is going to get a yellow card. Bianchi drew that as he, like, rushed Higgins, kind of bull rushed him.
I'm surprised he didn't get a yellow card, too, for that.
Yeah. A little retaliation by Bianchi. So Higgins picks up a yellow. Higgins may have had the assist on Hague's goal. Try to get another look at it. Starting to lose track. All this scoring.
No.
I mean, we're writing it in our books here. That happened in the 3-0 win at California. The third goal, I was busy tallying the second goal when Portland went up 3-0. The only thing I was able to see was Cameron Knowles celebrating.
Scott Thompson may have taken just a cleat in the midsection, I think, from Kim, chasing down that ball. Yeah, I have a little, like, a legal pad here, and I'll write down all the, you know, goals, substitutions, yellow cards, and usually I fill up maybe half the page, and I'm running out of lines here tonight because there are so many things happening to you.
2 minutes of stoppage time. The clock has been off for about 10 seconds here. At 90 minutes, 4-1 Portland. Whistle and a foul on California. No, on Portland, rather. Restart victory. The victory will have gone 0-for against the Timbers in 07. And that's a big deal because they played Portland 5 times. It's kind of like back in the day when Edmonton was in the league. Even Calgary got a win against Portland. Many, but Hague looking for four. No, it's cleared away by Schwartz.
I don't want to have to look up the last Timber to score 4 goals.
Oh, come on, yes you do.
No, I think this is enough for tonight. Timbers don't need to rub it anymore.
Obviously the red card played a part in this because it put California down a man and really kept them from being able to move forward with confidence.
Yeah, from 1-1 to 4-1 in the time since the red card.
But also, I think it's certainly worth mentioning the insertion of Sean Higgins into the lineup paid huge dividends before the red and certainly after the red. And then, you know, Hague coming on and just clinical.
Well, as we said, I mean, it's up to the Timbers to take advantage of the extra man and actually make it, and they have to 3 goals. They've created opportunities and taken advantage with some great finishing by David Hague.
The Timbers had 2 shots as a team in the first half. Hague's got 4 by himself in about 20 minutes, including 3 goals, and that is it. The Timbers over the California victory by a final score of 4-1, David Hague, the natural hat trick in this one. And Portland is now in first place in the first division, the first team in USL 1 to 30 points here in 2007. Halfway through the season, the Timbers remain unbeaten at home, and they take care of California for the 5th and final time here in 07. Our postgame show comes your way next on the Portland Timbers Broadcast Network.
I'm a yellow notepad, 28 lines per page, with a few French fry stains. Not exactly high-end technology, but I don't mind. You see, I'm the yellow pad Portland General Electric engineer Steve Higgins used to sketch out his thoughts when PGE joined in a team effort to bring more wind turbines to Oregon. And now, after hours in his pickup and construction trailers, those turbines are real, pretty much like Steve scratched them on the surface. Dozens of towering new windmills churning out the kind of clean, limitless, sustainable power that all Oregonians can be proud of, that they can be part of. As for me, I think I'll be around a while, dog ears and all. People may work on computers, but they dream on yellow pads.
Hi, I'm Steve Higgins, inviting you to sign up for renewable power. For details, visit PortlandGeneral.com or call 503-228-6322. PGE, we do this every day.
The sound you're hearing is 170 engineers heading for work at Shindaiwa. 170 engineers whose only goal is to make sure that every time you start a piece of Shindaiwa outdoor power equipment, it sounds like this. Save an additional $35 on a Shindaiwa trimmer. Log on to Shindaiwa.com to find an authorized dealer near you. Backed by 170 engineers and a full money-back guarantee. The first to start and the last to quit.
Better Beer Bureau, how can I help you?
Yes, I just tried Miller Lite for the first time, and I'm getting this sensation in my tongue area.
Sir, that sounds like taste. A perfectly normal reaction to the full-bodied flavor of Miller Lite.
Taste? But I've been drinking light beer for years. I've never experienced taste before.
Yeah, we get that a lot from new Miller Lite drinkers. See, some light beers have a watered-down taste, but Miller Lite is brewed to taste like a real beer should.
So I'm normal.
Better than normal, sir. Thanks for calling the Better Beer Bureau.
Great tasting, never watered down. Miller Lite. Good call. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Live responsibly.
Timbers have just five home matches remaining in league play here in 2007, but they have made the most of their matches thus far, winning six, drawing threes, remaining unbeaten with their 4-1 win here tonight. The Portland Timbers eclipsing their earlier season high for goals in a game set twice. They scored three in the opener against Puerto Rico, and then three more just over a week ago at California. And then tonight, they score four times. It's the most goals for the Timbers since the September match back in 2005 when former Timber Dan Antoniuk scored a hat trick, leading Portland to a 6-1 win against his team, his current team, Atlanta. David Haig, the first hat trick since then. A natural hattie as he scored three in a row, busting open a 1-1 match. The Timbers scored four unanswered in this one and run away with a victory by a final of 4-1. John Strong has headed down to the pitch for some post-game comments. We'll have David Haig, Luke Kremelmeyer, head coach Gavin Wilkinson coming up in our post-game show today. 4-1 in favor of the Portland Timbers. And I mentioned four straight. It was Bianchi officially getting credit for the first goal. It appeared to deflect off of Chandler. It deflected off of something in front. Josh Wicks had no chance because of the deflection. Kind of a lucky goal, really, for California. But it was their first in five matches against Portland this year, and that made it 1-0 in their favor in the 18th minute. However, Cameron Knowles evened the score thanks to a great ball from Greger and a better ball from Luke Kremelmeyer, who flicked it to Knowles at the back post, and Knowles just had to walk into the empty net with the ball, and that made it 1-1. In the second half, California a chance in front. They just absolutely blew it. A couple players had open goal looks and could not put anything on target, and they would pay the price because they lost Ricardo Sanchez to a red card. Sanchez put his spikes into the midsection of Brian Jordan. The referee felt that was red card worthy, sent him off, and the Timbers took their time, I guess you could say, about 12 minutes or so. Actually, it was the 55th minute, so 13 minutes. David Haig came on from Greger in the 68th, and it was Haig again in the 75th from Josh Wicks, picking up assist number two on the year. And then Haig.